In the previous video, I talked about the development of nasal cavity. In continuation with the nasal cavities, today I am going to talk about the development of palate. Now, palate is basically composed of primary palate and the secondary palate, right? So, the primary palate and the secondary palate, they develop from different sources. That is why they have been given the name of primary as well as secondary. Now, for this, you need to know what is intermaxillary secretion. Intermaxillary secretion. Now, this portion in red is the intermaxillary secretion. What happens is after the medial nasal prominences fuse, not only at the surface but at the deeper level, there is formation of a midline structure that is known as intermaxillary secret. As the name you can make out, as the name suggests, intermaxillary means it is present between the two maxillae, right? So, the intermaxillary segment is basically composed of the medial nasal prominences fused at the surface as well as at the deeper level, right? And this is again made up of three components. One is the upper lip component. Upper lip component means it is forming the philtrum of the upper lip. Then there is upper jaw component. Now this upper jaw component carries four incisors. These are the four incisors, upper four incisors. So this is the upper lip component, upper jaw component, and then the third one is the palatal. Triangular primary palate. As you can see, this develops and forms the triangular primary palate. Now, this triangular primary palate at its junction, that is at its fusion of the triangle, forms a foramen that is known as incisive foramen. This incisive foramen is the demarcating line between the primary palate and the secondary palate I am going to talk about. So, the triangular primary palate fuses in the midline at the level of incisive foramen, right? Now, posteriorly there is a different structure you can see. Now, this structure is coming basically from the maxillary prominence. These two are the maxillary prominences, and when these maxillary prominences give rise to a midline, or you can say towards the medial side, they give rise to two shelves, shelf-like structures. These shelf-like structures have been named as palatine shelves. These two are the palatine shelves. Because they are going to form the secondary palate, that is why they have been named as palatine shelves, coming from the medial portion of the maxillary prominences on either side. Again, they are paired structures. Now, when they grow towards the midline, or you can say when they grow towards each other and fuse in the midline, this is how the structure develops. They grow towards the midline and fuse with each other, forming the secondary palate. Fusion here is shown. These are the palatine shelves. Then this is the nasal septum. This is the primary palate. And here you can see the junction of the primary palate with the secondary palate is at the incisive foramen. Fine. So you will have a structure that is the palate as a whole developing from two components. One is the primary palate and the secondary palate, and they together fuse with each other. Secondary palate fuses with the primary palate as well as with each other, and that is how the whole of the palate is developed. This is the incisive foramen, which is the demarcating line between the primary and the secondary palate. Right. Now, the palatine shelves, these palatine shelves which are responsible for the formation of secondary palate, they develop at the sixth week of intrauterine life. Right. And they are initially present obliquely downwards. This is tongue. And these are the two palatine shelves directed obliquely downwards at the 6th week of intrauterine life. What happens is, at the 7th week of intrauterine life, these palatine shelves ascend up and become horizontal. As you can see in this picture, they ascend up and become horizontal, and the tongue falls downward from between these two, right? That is how the 7th week of intrauterine life, these two palatine shelves fuse with each other and become horizontal in nature, making the tongue fall downwards. Now, this important description is very important. Palatine shelves developing at 6th week of intrauterine life, and then they become horizontal, making the tongue fall downwards and between these two palatine shelves at the 7th week of intrauterine. We'll consider this when we'll talk about the cleft palate anomaly, right? So this is how the normal development of the palate is from the primary and the secondary palate, and these two palatine shelves become horizontal at 7th week of intrauterine life, right? That completes the development of palate. And this palate is the demarcating line between the nasal cavities and the oral cavities. Rostral attachment of the nasal cavities or the nasal septum is at the palate. Whereas posteriorly, the bucconasal membrane dissolves and there is a communication between the oral cavity and the nasal cavity. That we have already talked about when we were discussing the development of nasal cavities. So these two are basically interconnected with each other. That completes the development of palate. Thank you.